times you were drunk and your buddies or girlfriends dared you to do something. And you did it.
Wow, Drew, you savage. I was drunkenly dared to pick up a jellyfish by one friend, and then the other friend dared me to throw it at the first friend. I did both. Oh, you got to be a special level of drunk to hand pick up a jellyfish and fastball it at your friend. Also down at the beach, Ralph got so drunk once that he got his belly button pierced and sent us in a photo of it.
Dared a drunk buddy to rob a closed corner gas station.
Whoa.
That's like a crime.
That's just criminal. That's criminal mischief.
Broke the front window, ran in, was so drunk he just slipped and fell everywhere because there was snow on the grounds.
That's hilarious.
Went in the next day, the owner said he had been vandalized, but nothing was stolen.
Give me all the money from the cash register. I'll have a Slim Jim. Let's go to the phones, 410-338-1098. Let's go to Chris in the district. Chris, good morning, bud.
Hey, good morning, guys. How you doing?
Very well. Thank you for holding.
Oh, no problem. By the way, Jock Spiegel's perfect.
Yeah.
Jock Spiegel.
And every Jock Spiegel in sports. Jock Spiegel might get a jersey made from the Ravens.
Well, anyways, yeah, so my nickname is Cornbread, so some of my friends are probably listening, but a long time ago, right out of college, we were down in D.C., and I was actually the designated driver, and I took my friends out to a bunch of Christmas parties. After a few hours, we dropped off my truck, and I just proceeded to do a multitude of whiskey shots, Jameson, whatever you got.
You
got to
catch
and
up.
We're walking, and yeah, I definitely caught up, and I caught up fast in about 2 hours. And after the bars were closed, and we were walking through Georgetown, and my buddies were all fresh out of college, and we looked at each other, and we saw this British flag hanging off of a house.
Oh, no.
And we said to one guy, we were like, yeah, you think you can get it? He's like, yeah, yeah, I can get it. So he walked over to the fence, stood on the wrought iron fence, tried to stand up and reach it and couldn't get it. So I just said, get out of the way. I'll do it.
No.
And so I stood up on the fence, and I had, you know how the A6 and the arch is all plastic?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Cold December night.
Nope.
Not realizing how heavy the flag was, I reached up, pulled it off, and I spun and fell straight down.
Oh! You stab yourself?
I'm looking eye to eye with my friends, and they're like, are you all right? And I'm like, yeah, I'm fine. I go to slide off, and my right ass cheek falls off my fence, but the left ass cheek was skewered.
Skewered your ass cheek. Oh, you got a huge ass cheek wound because you needed a flag.
Oh, yeah. So I'm sitting there. My buddies are looking at me, and I'm, you know, I grew up with my mom being a nurse. I know not to pull any punctured things out, but I stood up.
Oh.
And at that moment, it was like the Wile E. Coyote, where like when he would go off the cliff and the blood hits the middle of his eyes and he falls, I felt the blood just draining out of me, and I just fell forward and smashed my head on the sidewalk.
Oh, congratulations. You got Dennis Miller tickets. Mike, he's on hold. Just very first call, that good. You had a butt wound, a head wound, a stolen flag, a designated driver. That couldn't have been anything but. And as a rule, never play catch-up. You always overshoot the target.
It's a lose-lose.
Let's go to Sean. Harford County's been holding for a bit. Sean, good morning.
Well, hello there.
Well, hello there.
Ha! All right. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, bud.
I had a ex-girlfriend at the time. Dared me $5 to drink two of those Papa John's garlic sauce.
Oh.
Which one?
The little garlic sauce.
Oh, garlic sauce.
Those are good.
Yeah, but you chug them.
Yes.
I don't know if they're
Let's just say I got $5 out of that deal.
All right. I mean, yeah.
Chugs.
Yeah, and you also probably got IBS, too. Yeah, you got to dip. You got to dip. You don't chug. Let's talk to, okay, speaking of eating something, let's go to Rachel and Falston. Rachel, good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Hi.
So my story, so years ago when I was in high school, I was quite the party girl, and I was at somebody's house, and we were doing, you know, beer bongs and shots, and somebody dared me to eat an exotic pepper that was inside of this huge decorative wreath on somebody's mom's kitchen. And it was so old, I had to, like, wash the dust off of this pepper that I plucked out.
Oh.
And so I ate it. And at first, I'm chewing it up, and it didn't seem like that big of a deal. And immediately, my mouth started to burn. And let's just say a few minutes into it, I was rolling around on the floor in a cesspool of vomit, tears.
Why?
My eyes, because it was so hot, and I guess I was allergic to it. My lips swelled. My eyes swelled shut. I couldn't stop vomiting, screaming, and they had to call an ambulance and take me to the hospital.
Wow. Damn, bae.
Wow, that's a good story.
Yeah, don't eat dusty old pepper wreaths. Let's talk to Kevin, who's breaking a cardinal rule. Never mess with the keg. Never mess with the keg, Kevin.
What's going on, guys?
Oh, boy.
What up?
We were out at a couple buddies of mine years ago. We were out in Morgantown, West Virginia, and we were staying with some friends, and the neighbors had a keg sitting on the deck. So later in the night, I go, somebody's going to take a dump on their keg.
Oh, God.
So my buddy runs over there and poops on the top of the keg. I don't know why. I don't know why we would have even ruined it. So the next morning, they come ask, did you guys see anybody come on our deck last night? Somebody dropped a log on the keg. So they clean it up. The next night, dare them to do it again. So two nights in a row, he pooped on their keg.
Yeah, there you go. Double down on the dare. Ruined a perfectly good keg, but I love it. Good Lord. Oh, man. Let's do one more here. Let's talk to Jesse's been holding patiently for a while. Jesse, good morning.
Good morning, guys.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, I just want a quick shout out. I heard West Virginia mention a few times away from there. Go Mountaineers.
Shout out.
So me and my friends are hanging out one day, having a few brews. My one friend, he's got a man missing all on television, you know, and everyone knows that he tends to enjoy his own urine from time to time.
Oh, wow. Of course.
Yeah,
who doesn't?
Yeah.
So, you know who amongst us?
I drink Scots.
So I comment that it doesn't seem that bad. So my friend's like, oh, man, you wouldn't do it. And then I said, how much? So my friends are like, we'll give you
$30.
So I proceed to go in the bathroom and fill up a whole beer bottle and guzzle it down.
Oh, for 30? You could have got 100. Bottle. You could have got 100.
I tried. 30 was the highest you were going to go.
All right.
Well, got a good story out of it.
Yeah, you did. And probably some sort of permanent infection.
What if all of us cleaned our belly button lint out and lint from our socks and then put it in a beverage for Mike to drink?
Mike? You down, brother?
Well, first I'd have to get drunk, right?
No.
Not here at work.
What if we paid you?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's not even that bad. Belly button lint?
Oh, have you seen my belly button? It's a disaster.
What about upper inner thigh lint?